Cervical dystonia is the most frequent type of dystonia. It can present on a focal point of view, so just muscle of the neck can be involved, or can be part of a generalized dystonia or segmental dystonia, meaning that also other body districts are affected by dystonia. Surely, this is one of the most disabling dystonia, especially if it's not recognized and not treated properly and earlier on. It may manifest in many ways. Onset might occur with neck pain or involuntary head position, like rotation to one side or tilting to one side or flexion of the head or extension of the head. It also may manifest with tremor. Head tremor may be a manifestation of cervical dystonia. Often people have pain and involuntary torsional movements of the head, meaning that their head is rotated to one side or is tilted to the right or to the left. Those movements can be sustained. What does it mean, sustained? People can have tonic posturing of the head, so their head is fixed in that position. This is particularly challenging and disabling for the patient. Other subjects can have more quick movement, so those involuntary movement, they change the position of the head on one side, but then the patient is able to correct that position. Those are subjects who may benefit significantly from the treatment and also from rehabilitation treatment and the use of antagonist gest. What is antagonist gest or sensory trick? This is a maneuver that reverts the symptom of cervical dystonia. Often, people report that when touching the chin or touching the cheek, their dystonic symptoms in the neck, they immediately disappear or improve. Sometimes they can put their hands behind their head, or sometimes they notice that when closing their eyes, symptom may worsen on the opposite. Very rarely when closing the eyes, the symptom can improve. Other antagonist gestures can be very bizarre. For example, often people with cervical dystonia worsen when walking and improve when sitting. So just the act of sitting can improve the symptoms. This is an important message also for the neurologist, because it's fundamental to assess people with cervical dystonia when they are engaged in performing many activities, such as walking, but also lying down on the bed. Lying down on the bed may be a very important trigger for dystonia, and this is a cause of sleep disruption in cervical dystonia. And for this reason, sleep impairment may be a symptom of very severe cervical dystonia. So in summary, this condition may manifest with different symptoms: abnormal head posture, pain, sleep, but also emotional symptoms due to the disability developed for cervical dystonia, like anxiety or even depression, or even lack of confidence and not wanting to perform social activity because of social embarrassment, which is the frequency of cervical dystonia. Also for this condition, there are several studies reporting different frequencies. They range from 20 to 183 subjects per million inhabitants. It depends on the geographical area of the studies, and also it depends on the type of the study, the screening instrument used. Surely it shouldn't be forgotten that dystonia is often underestimated. The treatment for cervical dystonia include botulinum toxin, physiotherapy, oral medications, and deep brain stimulation. All this treatment can be combined, especially botulinum toxin with physiotherapy. Surely physiotherapy enhances and prolongs the effect of botulinum toxin, despite still the scientific evidence is not strong yet, but it is the experience of the patient that might be treated with physiotherapy combined with botulinum toxin. Botulinum toxin is administered to neck muscles every 3 or 4 months, depending on the severity of the symptoms and the duration of the effect. The choice of the muscle is based on clinical examination by the neurologist, but also sometimes we use electromyography, EMG, to support the decision on which muscle to inject. More recently, we have used also ultrasound during the injection for the most challenging cases, when a good response is not achieved with clinical examination alone or even EMG. We also use the term laterocollis. In this case, the head is tilted to one side, right or left. Also, we have people with retrocollis, where the head is extended backwards, or anticollis, where the head is as an abnormal flexion forward. It's important to say that those different head positions can be combined, so people can have a combination of torticollis with laterocollis, or combination with anticollis and laterocollis. This creates the difficulty because clinical examination is aimed to define the different component of cervical dystonia. I give you a very easy example. A patient can have as a primary component torticollis and then as a secondary component lateralcollis, meaning tilting, but also tremor. And with our treatment with botulinum toxin, we must tackle all these components. So also the shoulder is affected in cervical dystonia. People can have shoulder elevation on one side, and often the pain is localized to the shoulder, even in the lower part of the shoulder. And again, this is a target for botulinum toxin that is able to improve also pain, often in cervical dystonia. So oral medication can be used besides botulinum toxin to treat cervical dystonia. We might use clonazepam, which is effective for tremor, dystonic head tremor. Sometimes we can use other medication like anticholinergic drugs, but more rarely, like triacetylphenidyl. And also we employ medication that may be helpful for very sustained muscle contractions. So these are medication that are muscle relaxants. One of these medication is baclofen. Also, people with cervical dystonia can be treated with pain medication. This is a very frequent occurrence in this population, or also antidepressant or medication for anxiety or sleep medication. Again, the role of botulinum toxin is very important because the aim is to treat most of the sign of dystonia with this medication and allow subject not to be treated with a multiple type of medication. However, if botulinum toxin is not effective, other medication for pain, muscle relaxation, depression, and anxiety can be used.